Hi guys, welcome back to another video. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, welcome. My name is Victoria and I film from Lagos, Nigeria. So do well to join the family, subscribe, okay? And to my returning subscribers, thank you for always coming back to watch my video. I really love and appreciate your support. Thank you guys. So in today's video, we'll be talking about 6 things to do if you feel like your account has been hacked. Okay, that's your Microsoft 365 account. I don't know of any other account, but we are specifically talking about Microsoft 365 account. So yeah, 6 things you can do if you feel like your account has been hacked, or 6 things you can do to fix an hacked account. Okay, without further ado, let's get right into this video. So if this is something you like to watch or something you like to know about, please watch this video to the end, okay? And also, if you can hear any background noise, is my fan, okay? I need this fan to blow on me because this weather is too hot. Alright, so I'm sorry about that. But let's jump right into the video, okay? So the first thing you can do if you feel like your account has been hacked or to fix your account is to change your password. That's reset your password. I made a video on this, like a whole video on this, so you can check that out to see how you can reset your password. Okay, so one thing you can do, or the number one thing you can do, is to reset your password. Okay, the next thing you can do is to scan your devices for malware. Okay, so you can download a good antivirus on your laptop or on your phone to scan if you have any malware on your device. Okay, yeah. The next one is review your mailbox rules. Yeah, so most people, when I was working as a customer support, Microsoft customer support, we usually get this complaint a lot that, oh, I'm not receiving my email is going into, like, my account has been hacked and I'm not receiving my email, is going to someone else's email or something like that. But funny enough, it's not going anywhere, it's not delivering to any other person. It's on their, it's in their mailbox, but it's just the hacker has already created a rule on their account, so it's moving that email, any new email is moving it to another mailbox. Maybe they create a new mailbox a new folder in their mailbox, and those messages are going, or those emails are going into that mailbox folder. So it's not like it's going someone else. So you need to, if you are in this situation, so you need to check your mailbox rule, review it. If you see any rule that you did not create, so you need to delete them, and you would find out that you will start receiving your emails on the right folder, like that's in your inbox. So after doing this, if you want to see your previous maybe received emails that you were like, oh, this person sent me an email but I didn't see it, so try to check your folders. You see, or before you delete any rule, you check what rule was it. So you will see something like incoming or inbox to be forwarded to conversation folder, or inbox should be forwarded to outbox or any other folder on that list. So you try to check that rule before you delete it. So you check your folders and check for any strange folder there. You will definitely see your mails there. All you need to do is forward them to the right list. Like if the mails in that folder are for your inbox, just make sure you forward them to your inbox and you are good to go. So that leads to the next one, which says review mail forwarding. So on the rules, if you see any mail forwarding, or if you realize that your mails are going into another folder, or you just notice any funny mail forwarding, you can go ahead to correct that. So your inbox or whatever folder is going into, whatever mail that is coming in is going into the right folder. Okay, then the last one, which as I've already explained, that you should move any emails that were deleted or moved to a new folder. That means if you have like your mails that those accounts have moved to a deleted folder or a new folder, if they have moved it to a new folder, just basically all you need to do is to move it back to that to the right folder. So that's all you need to do. Okay, and the last point is to turn on two-step verification. So what you need to do is go to your Microsoft account and turn on two-step verification. If you don't know how to do this, let me know in the comment section and I'll be right, like I'll try to explain how you can do this. Okay, yeah, so if you have gained something from this video, let me know in the comment section, and if you have any question, let me know in the comment section. Okay, thank you so much guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Do well to click on the like button, share your lovely comment, share this video and all those good stuff. I'll see you in the next one. Bye guys.